Hello, Dr. Gordon. I want to play a game. As you know, today is Wednesday, and at 11:20 a.m., an emergency alert test will be conducted on all phones in America. I've hooked up 30 phones to the loudspeaker. Somewhere in this room, there's a button to shut them all down. If you do not hit the button in time, your ears will be destroyed. You have 10 seconds to find the button.
Was that supposed to be about the national alert from last week?
Yeah, but I think I'll pass. I like Friday the 13th more than I like Saw.
Well, speaking of which,
good afternoon, Pios! Today is Friday, October 13th, 2023. Hey, Natalie, you know what sounds good right now?
What, Maverick?
I'm thinking something small, round, and colorful.
Small, round, and colorful? M&M's?
Ding, ding, ding. You got it.
Oh my gosh, Maverick, that does sound good. We should grab some after the show.
Duh, of course. I'm Maverick.
And I'm Natalie.
And this is the Pioneer Press First of Colors edition.
Pios, it's that time of the week again. Finally, after a three-week wait, the long-awaited hashtag PioPress is now back. We'll be featuring some pictures from 3 weeks ago. Steven, roll it. Keep rocking and keep knocking. Whether you Louis Vuitton it up or Reebokin', you see the hate that they serving on a platter. So what we gon' have, dessert or dessert? I never thought I'd be in love like this. When I look at you, my mind goes on a trip. Then you came in. Thank you for sending those in, Pios.
Wes's speech team is looking for new members, and Miss Rusk is the coach. The speech team practices both soapbox speech and mikvah strategies that some of you already may be familiar with. Speech team members will cultivate and practice the following skills using speech topics chosen by you. The speakers research interviewing, writing, speaking, and competition.
Miss Rusk will be holding a speech team practice and a quarter three speech competition here at Western. Western's winners then have the opportunity to participate in AUHSD's Soapbox Speech Competition in spring of 2024. All speech team members can even submit their own speeches to Mikvah for potential national competitions.
If you're interested in joining, email Ms. Rusk at rusk_k@auhsd.us. Or stop by room 10 during Ms. Rust's Tuesday office hours, 3:30 to 4:30, to discuss what Western Speech Team does. Currently, there is a youth speed contest right here in Orange County with cash prizes for first $500, second $300, and third $200 place winners.
See Ms. Rusk for more information and the youth speed contest flyers around the campus. Ms. Rusk can also help you develop this speech if you are interested.
The Astronomy Club will be meeting this Friday at lunch in room 31. There is a fun activity plan. We will discuss the telescope we would like to purchase and talk about our first event.
Astronomy Club's first event will be this Saturday during Saturday Academy. We will be viewing the partial solar eclipse. Sign up to view the eclipse with your peers. Learn about how and why an eclipse occurs, why they don't happen every month, and how to view one safely. Eclipse viewing glasses will be available for you to use.
Pios, this is an invitation for each one of you to come and join us for a memorable evening at our first annual Arab Cultural Night at Western High School on Friday, October 20th from 5 to 7:30 p.m.
Here's what to expect.
Dab Kid dance.
Delicious food.
Live music.
And authentic Arab culture products.
We couldn't have organized this event without your support, and we sincerely hope to see you there sharing this cultural celebration with us.
Please save the date and feel free to bring your friends and family to join in the festivities.
We look forward to celebrating the beauty of Arab culture together at Western High School's first annual Arab Cultural Night.
Pios, we have two videos for Hispanic Heritage Month from Ms. Castro's AP class. Steven, roll it.
Bienvenidos a este viaje a través del tiempo sobre los corridos en la cultura hispana. Yo soy Annie.
Yo soy Mariano.
Yo soy Kimberly.
Y yo soy Perla.
Y nosotros somos de la clase de español para hispanohablantes 3.
Los corridos son canciones narrativas que han desempeñado un papel crucial en la tradición musical de habla hispana durante siglos. And now we're going to go around to see how well our pioneers know some famous artists.
What's your name?
Justin.
Last name?
Martinez.
My name is Luis.
Tech. So we're going to have you guess two artists, okay? Can you guess them?
That one's Peso Pluma, uh-huh. And that one's Nata.
I did the same.
No, they're two different people.
It's Peso Pluma.
Uh-huh.
I don't know, Ivan Cornejo.
Ivan Cornejo.
One of the greatest artists we showed is Natanael Cano. Natanael Cabo tuvo un gran impacto en la cultura hispana gracias a su enfoque en la música regional mexicana. Algunas de sus canciones como Amor Tumbado, PRC, Mi Bello Ángel y más, a través de su estilo, captó a una audiencia más joven y diversa que antes no estaba tan involucrado en la música regional.
I'm sure you guys have heard of the famous artist Peso Pluma. El éxito de Peso Pluma se debe en parte a la presencia de una gran comunidad mexicana en los Estados Unidos, lo que ha ayudado a mantener una fuerte conexión con la cultura hispana. Le tomó un par de días para colocarse en el hit mundial de Spotify. Además de eso, en menos de una hora de sus canciones ya estaba colocada como la canción más escuchada de todo México.
¿Cómo te llamas?
Dylan Juárez.
Barry.
Te vamos a preguntar cómo se llaman estos artistas famosos.
Okay. Junior H y Grupo Frontera.
Junior H, uh-huh. And I think that's Grupo Frontera.
Have you heard of this song? Pues él es Junior H. Ha logrado reconocimiento en varios países hispanos, especialmente en Chile y otros países latinoamericanos. Relaciona la cultura hispana con su estilo musical innovador y su habilidad para conectar con audiencias jóvenes. Junior H ganó reconocimiento en los premios de Mejor Artista y Mejor Álbum.
Otro de los artistas que han tenido un gran impacto en la comunidad hispana es el Grupo Frontera. Ellos son una banda que tiene muchas canciones populares. ¿Conocen a esta? Ya nada me hace reír. Uno de los logros que han tenido es ganar el premio de reconocimiento tanto en México como al sur de los Estados Unidos debido a su interpretación de la canción No Se Ve.
I hope you remember these accomplishments that some of these greatest artists have made possible. Thank you, Pios, for listening and learning something new about the impact of the corridos that have had in the Hispanic community. Bye!
Hola, Pios.
Yo soy Gonzalo Rivera.
Yo soy Nicole Alarcón.
Yo soy April Zuniga.
Yo soy Kiara.
Y yo soy Héctor Rangel.
Y este es nuestro video sobre Guillermo del Toro.
Guillermo del Toro, born October 9, 1964, began his career in Mexico with movies like Cronos and The Devil's Backbone, which helped showcase his talent for blending in fantasy with real-world issues. He's also a master of monsters, as in his movie Hellboy, he uses amazing costume design and VFX use, which helps showcase his talent for making supernatural feel real.
Del Toro's work often features Hispanic characters and themes, which provides representation for the Hispanic community in the film industry. For example, in Pan's Labyrinth, he set the story in post-Civil War in Spain and incorporated elements of Spanish culture and history, which resonated with Hispanic audiences.
El talento del Toro no termina en la acción en vivo. Recientemente, Guillermo del Toro también hizo Pinocho, que ganó el premio de más académico de la mejor película en animación.
También productor ejecutivo y actor de doblaje, Del Toro ayudó a producir Shrek 3 e incluso prestó su voz para la película El Gato con Botas, que también prosperó con la cultura española.
Bro, Stranger Things? Ghostbusters. Hellboy.
Oh,
so smart.
Oh, Book of Life.
Oh,
Book of Life, homie. Bro, I watch that movie every day. They never gave me mine.
Man of Steel.
And then just said
Pinocchio.
I said that first.
El impacto de Guillermo del Toro se extiende más allá de la pantalla. Es un defensor de la diversidad en el cine y apoya a las minorías de la industria.
Through his films, Del Toro has celebrated Hispanic culture and folklore. He has incorporated elements of Mexican and Spanish culture in his work, shedding light on the rich traditions and stories from these regions.
Gracias por darnos tu atención.
Bye. Tati Tomás. Tati Tomás.
No mames, güey.
Bájala por talento de.
Through his fail.
Great job, pioneers, for guessing those Hispanic artists and movies.
As part of this year's Hispanic Heritage Month, celebrating some of Ms. Galarraz's AP students created short videos to highlight how they see themselves in the future. This project helped them reflect on their past, their present, and envision where they see themselves in the future.
Let's watch today's second video and help us celebrate future Hispanic Latino icon leaders. Here is today's video by sophomore Mashana Kular. We know your dreams will come true.
Pios, do you enjoy writing or drawing?
Submit your work to Dial Magazine for a chance to be featured in this semester's issue. Submissions will close this Sunday at 11:59 p.m.
Listen up, seniors! Gear Up is hosting a workshop Tuesday, October 24th. If you're part of the College and Career Leaders Team, be there to learn about the second step to becoming a leader with Gear Up.
Pio, since Halloween is around the corner, we decided to send out Jasmine to ask a couple of our pioneers some questions. Steven, roll it.
Hey Pios, it's Jasmine and it's getting close to Halloween, so let's go ask Pios questions about Halloween. Hi, Jasmine, what's your name?
Michael,
okay. If you were to collect candy while trick-or-treating on Halloween, A, you could only choose one type of candy to fill your bag. What candy would you pick and why?
I choose Skittles because like all the flavors are has different flavors and it tastes good.
That's a good answer, thank you. Okay, hi, I'm Jasmine, what's your name?
Sarah Michelle.
Oh, that's your name. Okay, so if you were to host a Halloween movie night with your friends, which three classic monster movies would you feature in your lineup and why would you choose that?
The first one would be The Night Before Christmas because it's just like a classic, it's really good. Then the second one would be It, because who doesn't love a good clown movie? The third would be The Chainsaw Massacre, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. I don't know, I just really like it. Okay, thank you. Hi, Jasmine, what's your name?
Tanzimar Bob.
And that's a cool name. Okay, so my question is, if you were to host a Halloween movie night with your friends, which three classic monster movies would you feature in your lineup and why?
The movie Caroline, because it's just a really beautiful movie. And then I would also do all the Halloween specials from Disney. And that's a really good movie because I really like all the episodes in that movie. And I would choose a really scary movie like The Conjuring 2. So it has sweet movies, childhood memories, and a scary movie too.
Okay, thank you. And that's all for Pals on the Street. Back to the show.
You know, I'm so excited for Halloween. Do you plan on dressing up?
Of course, but it's a surprise. Gotta wait for October 31st.
If you haven't heard, the Hispanic Club is gearing up and planning a lot of fun activities and collaborating with clubs and groups on the campus to bring a beautiful and traditional event of the Day of the Dead. It is a celebration of life that brings the whole community together. Every year, they have a big costume contest where you can dress up as a Katrina or Katrin and win prizes. Stay tuned today during your Pios period class and ask for a contest application if you want to enter the contest.
Dia de los Muertos is happening at Western High School on Friday, November 3rd from 5 to 8 p.m. Tell your friends and family because there's going to be lots of fun and food and activities for everyone. Also, if you want to help Hispanic Club do decorations for the event, you want to earn some community service hours, please see Ms. Galarza in room 42 and sign up to work this Saturday at our Saturday Academy.
And in sports! Pios, our football team will be traveling to Santa Ana Valley to face them off at 7 p.m. We wish our players good luck.
Congratulations to our girls volleyball team on their win yesterday's against Magnolia with a final score of 3-0. The girls are now on their way to CIF.
Go Big Blue! Congrats on the girls golf team who won their third consecutive Orange League Championship yesterday.
Next up is the League Championship Tournament next Wednesday, followed by CIF individuals and team in the coming weeks.
And that's all we have for today, Pios.
Today's outro song is Move Like Jagger by the American band Maroon 5. This day back in 2011, Moves Like Jagger was nominated for a Grammy Award for Best Pop Duo Group Performance at the 54th Grammy Awards.
And as always, Pios, make sure to stay connected with us on all your favorite social media platforms using @ThePioPress.
Be sure to tag us on all your favorite photos and videos using #PioPress.
If you would like to be featured as a wayback, throwback, or flashback, reach out using @ThePioPress.
As always, Pios, we hope you have a
fabulous,
fascinating,
fantastic,
fearless
Friday.
And we will see you again next Monday.
Press on, Pios!
I've got the moves, like Jagger. Maybe it's hard when you feel like you're broken and scarred. Nothing feels right, but when you're with me, I'll make you believe that I've got the key. Oh, so get in the car.